We are coming to you live from the Republic Broadcasting Network, where you can handle the truth. And I'd like to take the time to thank John Stadmiller and Mike S. for giving us the chance to tell you the truth. Good evening from Boston, Massachusetts. My name is Frank Allen. Tonight is kind of a sad night for the community. We have tonight a memorial to Kim Straub on TM Radio. And I'm going to forego everything except for station numbers. You can call into the show live and ask a question at 800-313-9443 or listen at 605-313-0163. And I encourage people to call in to 800-313-9443 and offer their prayers if they would like to, and make a comment, whatever you think. The number is 800-313-9443. Kim Straub took her own life. I learned of it last evening from Midge Mathis. She has been a friend of mine. She has been twice a guest on this show, more often on the Northeast Conference. She was also a true activist. She sacrificed her career in nursing to expose the atrocities that had befallen the TI community, and lastly, herself. Kim once took a spot in front of her local police station. Kim was passing out flyers that depicted her torture. Kim was summarily arrested, jailed, and then sent to a state asylum for her service to the community. In this time of struggle, we TIs must always remember that we are in the right. The operators are in the wrong. They try to make us believe that we are horrible, terrible people, and that we have done unspeakable crimes against the state. What you must remember is always maintain a positive attitude. Don't let them get to you. We are stronger than they are as a unit. That's why this community must remain tight. If something happens on the West Coast, we should hear about it on the East Coast in about 2 minutes with a phone call. We the people is not a phrase that is new to us. This term is self-evident in our being, in who we are. Most of us are citizens of the United States of America by birthright. There are others, their ancestors, born into slavery in our not too distant past. They were freed by the Emancipation Proclamation, and once again by the Bill of Rights. today. Some of them are immigrants. China, Russia, leaving their homes and passing through Ellis Island to learn of our great country. The taste, the word of freedom, still on their lips and in their hearts. The government of the United States failed Kim Straub. The government of the United States has failed to protect its citizens from tyranny from without and within. The United States government owes Kim's family an apology. Vladimir Putin once stated, the United States is at the top of his list of countries that fail to protect its citizens. What do you think he was speaking of? We take the best care of our troops abroad. We take the best care of everyone in the service as best that we can. But the citizens and the troops, when they come home, find themselves homeless. Now, I think that a veteran that comes home from a foreign war should get a brand new house, a piece of property, and whatever the hell else he wants. But what does he get? Homelessness. It's time for a change. So we won't have to have a solemn occasion as this to mourn one of our own who the government has once again failed to protect. Instead, traumatizing her with arrest, the citizens of the U.S. go to work each day and come home, play games, and go to sleep. They look forward to holidays so that they might do the same thing, continue to play their games, watch videos, ignoring what is going on within the government. I have learned things through research since I became a TI a little over 8 years ago that I don't believe. I don't believe that they can let a citizen down. A nurse who has taken care of hundreds and hundreds of patients. So these people look forward to holidays once again. So they might continue to play their games, ignoring what is going on within the government. The car they drive, the home in which they live, and their status on Facebook are more important. Everything is more important than the government. The government has become so big that we cannot talk to a congressman. We cannot speak to a senator. We are barred from it. We had one man from Maine speak to his congressman about this issue. He was met with two police officers at his home. So that is First Amendment rights. If you cannot speak to your representative, if you cannot speak to your senator, the system has failed you. The system has failed you horribly. The fate that looms before the entire country is as an unseen sword drawn at their throats. The entire population is in denial. All have been drawn into the establishment or the rush for the almighty dollar that used to buy enough groceries for the entire week and now will not even buy a cup of coffee. If she were here today, Kim would say, well, I really didn't do anything. I was just helping out. Kim did this all the time. Always. She picked the police station to pass out her flyers, because I think she wanted to see what they would do. She found out. As I've mentioned, this could be one of the things that drove her to take her own life. So the entire population is in denial. They look the other way. All have been drawn into the fight for the power of gold. What will befall the population? One thing is total surveillance everywhere that you go. Your car, your job. Right into your own bedroom when you shut the door. The Chinese scoring system has already started to be implemented by several companies, among them a company called Sifted. I had a TI bring this up to me that she found the word sifted in an email that she received. Well, the Chinese system indicates that if a citizen defies a state rule, such as smoking in a non-designated area, they will forfeit certain foods or luxuries for their family. Remember, this is coming to the U.S. Fail a second time, you will be deprived of the right to buy a car or real estate. Remember, there are several companies already established creating this in the United States. Kim Straub doesn't have to see that. She will be missed at the protests. She will be missed when we bring this to a close. I can't express enough how I feel to get back to the scoring system. You fail a third time, you are imprisoned, called a retraining area under government prescribed mind control. Fact. Another fact coming up. Pre-crime is the new doctrine initiated by the Attorney General of the United States. The simultaneously circulated memo went to all of the state attorneys. A device called the fMRI scanner, together with police work, will be used to categorize citizens to see if they are in fact capable of committing a crime. Okay, we have to go to commercial, folks. We'll be right back with the rain.
Folks, we're living in a world the likes of which we've never perceived any clearer than we do now. The plan for global governance has been in the works for generations and would have likely been achieved by now but for the fact that the globalists left open their Achilles heel. With all their tools, Federal Reserve System, fiat currency, No Child Left Behind, and then Common Core education introduced to our schools to dumb us down, vaccines, pharmaceuticals to lobotomize us, GMO foods, insertion of compromised or bought and paid for politicians, judges, mainstream media propaganda, all pieced together like a puzzle designed to ultimately bring the world under submission. But with all their strategy, they forgot one thing: knowledge. And knowledge is power. With knowledge, their bombardment is nullified. Folks, with that, as brilliant and knowledgeable as you've become, among the wisest audience of any radio audience in the world, and you are, I want you to take a moment to reflect and ask yourself, how much of that knowledge did I obtain from Republic Broadcasting Network? How high has my consciousness been raised since I've been a listener? How fast am I now able to discriminate truth from fake news by being a Republic Broadcasting listener? How clear am I now able to see the world since I've been listening to RBN? Ask yourselves those questions, folks. Then ask yourself, what is that knowledge worth to me? Like my morning coffee, how would I survive without it? A voice of truth in a sea of lies. Do we not all need to make sure it survives? Like public broadcasting, we are now finding we can only survive with listener support. Censorship, advertisers being attacked, truth itself being attacked. It's the only way through this. We at Republic Broadcasting humbly ask you to become a supporter. Look at your budget and make a determination of what Republic Broadcasting is worth to you and what you can afford on a monthly basis. Go to republicbroadcasting.org and pledge 20, 30, 40, 50, if possible, 100 a month or more if it's affordable. Click the donate button and become a regular monthly donor. Assure both us and yourself that Republic Broadcasting truth will continue to flow like that morning coffee. The network thanks you.
It happens more often than we can imagine. In my case, I was sitting at home, and out of nowhere, I just started feeling uncomfortable. Then it got worse, and I started perspiring. I tried to ignore it, but I waited too long. The chest pain came as we were driving to the hospital emergency. I felt my life clock begin to tick. I barely survived. There was lots of damage done to my heart. What do I do now? I was lucky. I took a leap of faith and tried a 7-herb formula with hawthorn, garlic, cayenne, and more called Extendivite. Herbs have been used for thousands of years to keep us healthy. If you're not using Extendivite as a preventative supplement, maybe it's time to start. To order, call 1-877-928-8822 or visit heartdrop.com.
Extend your life with Extendivite.
Good evening from Boston, Massachusetts. My name is Frank Allen. Tonight, a memorial to a fallen TI, Kim Straub, on TM Radio. In case you've just tuned in, I'm going to forego everything except for the numbers to call in. You can call into the show live and ask a question or offer up a prayer at 800-313-9443, or you can listen at 605-313-0163. And now we'll go to Lorraine from Kentucky. Go ahead, Lorraine.
Hi, Frank. How are you? I considered Kim a friend, and I actually last heard from her October 24th. And I am so saddened to hear of this horrific news. I wish there was something I could have done or said.
I know she is not somebody that I would even remotely think of as taking her own life.
But no.
This shows us that we have to reach out to each other all the time. If you think that person is in good shape, fine, call them up. Doesn't matter. Some people put on a really good poker face. Well, and we can't see him.
You know,
I think
he was upset.
What's that, Lorraine?
I know she was upset. Some of her last correspondence was about what was being done to her dogs. And she loved those dogs. That's why I'm a little confused and suspicious. But, you know, no one knows what goes on in the minds of anybody else. And unfortunately, with what happens to us, you know, our lives can change on a dime. It's so disheartening. It's so sad. And I wish I would have known what happened from our last correspondence to that moment.
Right. She was a guest on our show in October. And I really, like I say, she was together, you know, and they must have really been on her bad, or something else happened. I think
right.
I'm going to give the police a call in her locale and just have them investigate a little further, or at least get more details of what happened so that I can let you all know. But I don't want to do this again. It tore me up just to write this. I don't want to do this again. Let's stay tight. Stay committed to each other. Put down the petty bickering. What counts are the TIs, the community. That's what counts. That's what's important. That's what we are supporting. Leave your phone lines open like I do for calls. And let's develop a phone tree. There's days where I could use a call. And, you know, right out of the blue, somebody will. But they didn't call Kim. It's not their fault. There are so many TIs now. We have to really develop a phone tree. This idea came from Kate Ryan out in Western Massachusetts. And it really worked well. And I think it's something that we should implement. We have a commercial coming up, Lorraine. You want to hang on through it?
Sure.
Okay. Okay, thank you. We're going to commercial for station ID. Thanks for listening.
You are tuned in to the Republic Broadcasting Network. Visit our website by going to republicbroadcasting.org.
Tired of being lied to by mass media? It's growing more and more apparent today that news is received less and less through standard media outlets. Even with a growing audience every day, RBN is beginning to direct more efforts into social media. Social media and the use of the internet is fast becoming the primary source of people for news, regardless of demographic. RBN has set out to provide some of the best news on the internet through republicbroadcasting.org and also has begun to use the tools to our advantage by way of social media. Republic Broadcasting is now operating a Facebook page to function as yet another avenue to have our collective voice reach new audiences across not only America, but across the globe as well. The Facebook page features not only news, but also an RBN player to listen to our broadcast. Get involved by visiting facebook.com/republicbroadcasting and liking our page and share it with your friends and family, because you can handle the truth.
Many people write us about their experience with Extendivite. Allow me to read you some from Amazon.com. It really does work like the review says it does. I cannot believe that after the first few days, I didn't feel as sluggish or clogged up. It has had a profound impact on my physical, emotional well-being. I'm skeptical as most people about products and their claims, and I never write reviews, but this is a wonderful product and I recommend it to everyone. Great product. It has brought my blood pressure from the mid-150s over the 80s to the mid-130s over mid-80s. Along with diet and exercise in just the past couple of months. Excellent. Thank you, David. Tell us your story. Get Extendivite today. Call 1-877-928-8822 or visit heartdrop.com.
Extend your life with Extendivite.
Hey, honey, I'm home. I grabbed the newspaper on the way home. Look at all the news today.
The newspaper? Don't you know that all you're going to get in the newspaper is propaganda, twisted news, and false information?
Honey, this is a national newspaper. It has to be true.
Ha! For some reason, a majority of the population believe anything the mainstream media tells them. The newspaper does not give out the important attention on what's happening to this country and news that affects our daily lives. Say, does that newspaper mention anything about the North American Union?
No, not that I can see.
I didn't think so. You need to go to www.newswithviews.com, where truth is more important than political correctness. That's www.newswithviews.com. Hey, don't throw that away. We can use that in the birdcage.
Okay, move over. Let me start reading newswithviews.com.
The truth? Read all about it at newswithviews.com. Newswithviews.com, where reality shatters illusion.
Good evening from Boston, Massachusetts. My name is Frank. This is a solemn occasion. We have lost another TI. In case you've just tuned in, this is a memorial to Kim Straub. An activist fed up with what's going on. As John F. Kennedy warned in March 1962, those who make peaceful revolution impossible will make violent revolution inevitable. Okay, Lorraine, we've got Chris from Las Vegas, too.
Yes.
Well, good evening, Frank, and I'm very sorry to hear about the loss of one of our TI family and share your concerns about their loved ones they left behind, as well as the rest of us. And I can assure you, as somebody that's been targeted since at least August of 2012, that the psyche trauma and the exhaustion of being constantly under attack, the corruption of the so-called legal system run by the Bar Association, which has a secret hit list for those of us who try to inform ourselves and educate ourselves in the law to try to find peaceful resolution for these problems, we find ourselves targeted unceasingly. It doesn't stop. It goes on all the time. They've tried to murder me flat out twice by trying to provoke me to violence unsuccessfully, fortuitously. And I'm not sure that there haven't been a couple of other messages sent to me in the form of being backed into or this or that, and having people show up at the house. And, my studying of the law has obviously made me very targeted because I share the things that I've learned with others to try to assist them and protect them from being preyed upon by these mercenaries masquerading as public servants and so-called attorneys. But it's very, very difficult, this war of non-ceasing continuation for years and years, having your family destroyed, your property stolen. It's just, it's an assault that most people couldn't hold up to, and I'm thankful and blessed that I hold up pretty well and maintain my sense of humor pretty much in spite of being targeted and being continually harassed. But being a senior male, it certainly does not make it easy. I think you'd agree.
Yes, none of this is easy. I still can't believe it. And it baffles me that you're spending the best years of your life battling an unseen enemy. And I do mean battling every day. It's not like you
We are actually at war in this country, Frank. Most people don't cognize it because it's not a kinetic type of war that most people are familiar with, but it's a silent war. Treatise called Silent Weapons for Quiet Wars was written many years ago and deployed to the military training facilities to educate the brightest of the bright in these forms of carrying out this undetectable, not readily cognized form of warfare, of psycho-political warfare, war on the mind, the info war.
Yes, and speaking of info wars, we've been stepped on everywhere. Everyone who tells the truth about what is going on is stepped on.
I like to call it a truth jihad, a terror deemed to be a holy war, which is really an unholy war against the truth.
Exactly. And I don't know about you, but if I were in a foreign country, or say it's the United States, how would you like it if a foreign troop kicked your door in the morning? I don't think you'd like that country too much. Well, there were a lot of private citizens in Iraq and all over the place, all over the world, that didn't enjoy getting their doors kicked in by the U.S. Would you like that?
I think you're guest from Kentucky had something to say there, Frank.
I'm sorry. Go ahead, Lorraine.
Oh, no. I was thinking about Kim and what had happened to her last year. She was performing activist work by handing out flyers, and a police officer blindsided her, handcuffed her. Asking her about her gun, her weapon, which I believe in Tennessee and here, you know, you're allowed to own. But it was because of that police officer handcuffing her. He hauled her off to a mental facility where she had to stay for a while. That was traumatizing, especially the fact that she's a nurse. Right, she's an RN. And all she was doing was disseminating information. It's really disturbing. And I hope that that police officer and all the others that target innocent people, that in their final days, they suffer in a way unlike anything that we've gone through, because they are public servants. They're supposed to be serving us. They're supposed to be serving everybody without prejudice, without bias. And they've violated their oath. And I guarantee that that officer was instrumental, and others, and that institution, in what happened to Kim. And Kim was a good person. She was a kind-hearted woman. She loved her dogs. Her dogs were being tortured by this program to the point where she was having to carry them around in a pouch. And one of the last messages that I received from her was a photo of her dog who had been hit with direct energy, fell off the couch and broke its little foot, and it was wrapped in a bandage. And then she said something about she feared that she was going to have to be hauled off to another mental facility. And then her last message to me was, oh, no, that it's not going to happen. She feels very blessed. And that was the last I heard from her. And that was October 24th. You can thank him for the legal system for her murder. Not a suicide, it's a murder.
You know, Kim and Frank, there is a bright side to this dark moment, and that is Kim no longer has to suffer being a targeted individual on this evil planet. She's freed from it, and I'm sure she will be going to a much better place than what she was at here. Not that I recommend that for anybody other than natural causes, but there is a solace available whenever we finish this penance we're doing on this ungodly earth with these demoniacs running amok and these psychopaths torturing people for their own period self-interest or government policy-funded objectives of torturing the people as laboratory subjects, rats or insects, as they like to view us.
Lorraine?
Yes, thank you for sharing that. Kim is, as you said, now she's free from the pain and the torture. Unfortunately, you know, she has a daughter who found her and is now going to be traumatized and be without a mom. So this program, while Kim is free, I know in my heart that she would never leave her dogs or her daughter. So, yes, I'm highly suspicious of this either way, because Kim was one of the people who found her implants. And, I mean, the last I heard that she was being autopsied, but I would be really curious if anybody out there can find out the results of that autopsy.
Oh, I'll find out. Now, I'm going to call, as I said earlier, the police in her locale, and I will learn everything.
And I would have to look for it and see if I could find it, because, you know, during my move, it's been very hectic and placing my house on the market and then moving. But Kim and I had a conversation sometime towards the end of last year, and she found a medical website with her name on it as a test subject. She sent it to me to ask me to look for my name. I couldn't find my name under my married or maiden name. But her name was there, her age, everything about her. And her name was there multiple times under multiple locations. And I would imagine she located this website because she is an RN and has the wherewithal or knowledge to have looked in the correct place. I've never seen the website before, not familiar with it. Wouldn't have found it in a million years. But it, you know, if I do stumble across it, I will forward it along for others to view. Of course, now, you know, her name may have been removed. But it's so disturbing. I'm still having a hard time believing that she would have taken her life.
I don't either. Her personality traits in profile don't indicate that. I've spoken with her at length on several occasions, and she is not built that way. She's not wired
no,
that way.
No, she's a fighter. She's been researching and fighting and advocating, and I mean, I know people become more depressed around holidays, but I can't imagine she wouldn't have it left a note, contacted someone. It's just too suspicious, and that her daughter found her. Another trauma.
Right.
This program is all about creating trauma.
I said in our last broadcast that the holidays, the operators really bear down hard.
Oh,
and
yes.
They know that a lot of us are alone, and they use this time to try and destroy us. This
yes.
is historically the time of year that mm-hmm. we do lose friends. But I don't want to write something like this again, Lorraine and Chris. And we have to stick together, like I said. Call me, I'll call you. You call somebody else. And, you know, it works.
Yes. And Chris said something. I'd not heard this before, but I'm really curious and would like to hear more about it, where he said that the bar has a secret watch list. The bar?
I'm
sure.
Oh,
absolutely.
The bar association? Like the lawyers?
When you understand that the American Lawyers Guild was brought to this country as a warring force to destroy it from within. From the early hundreds of this last century, maybe from the very beginnings of this country, the agents of the king, the Barcons, the Bar Association, if you will, the British Archons Registry, are really a warring force. They're all on the same team. They've assimilated all separated powers of government. They have a total chokehold on the complete criminal justice system, because all the way up to the Supreme Court, there is a bar qualification to sit on the Supreme Court. The bar is a private association. It's not part of government, external to government. It gives you the illusion that they're fair and neutral and unbiased, but they act as judges, they act as prosecutors, they act as defenders. And therefore, they deceive the people into thinking that they're really on their side when they're really there to destroy you by any pretenses they can find lustfully satisfying, convenient, or financially rewarding.
Well, I agree with that for sure.
There was some really interesting law I was made privy to by going to a Supreme Court hearing here in Las Vegas last week. And I think I have it close by here. And I can tell you that this case tells us particularly, done by a highly prestigious law firm in the Las Vegas area, that the agents of government, FBI agents, FDA agents, police, are actually part of the prosecution team. So we think they're there to protect and serve us, and they're really serving the prosecution. And they do field interrogations, not informing you of your so-called Miranda rights to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. And they give you the illusion that they're there to help or be your friend while they're really undercover investigators for the prosecution team.
Yes.
You can see this is an unfortunate fact that we're not taught. And this is part of what I do that's made me a target, as I share this type of information with the American public and listeners on this and other shows, to try to let people know how dangerous it is to talk to the police. But then if they're supposed to be our protectors, who do we go to when we really have inside information of some devious or violent or dangerous to the public safety or the national security crime? If they're going to blame us for it because we know about it, because we've come privy of the knowledge, it destroys our whole faith in so-called institutions, as they like to refer to them. Trey Gowdy in particular refers to them in that fashion. If you've lost faith in your so-called institutions to protect you, because the only protection you truly has is with yourself and your inner circle, and even then you have to be very cautious of your inner circle. Are they really there to help you and truly your friends, or are they undercover investigators? Operation PatCon, a form of Operation Gladio.
Yes. Those are all good points. Yes. Well, you know, lawyers and liars, it sounds a lot alike.
Yes, they do, and they act a lot alike.
They do act a lot alike.
Okay,
Well, Tim will be missed, and I do hope in the coming months we can find out what really happened.
Well, I'll be on the phone for sure.
I hope somebody takes care of the dogs, too, and the daughter.
I'm sure Midge will be on the phone as well. So I think we will come up with some answers together.
Yes, because I'm sure that whatever happened, she would have wanted us to find out more, because that's what she was about. You know, she would send me photos of the stud finders and how she found implants in her body with the stud finder, and that she had X-rays. And she took such good care of those dogs. She was just so upset. But I know that she did not want to go back to a mental facility. She was afraid of that. So I don't know if something happened or transpired from, you know, October 24th in between there that was not shared. But again, you know, I'm not really suspicious by nature, but I'm really suspicious of this.
I agree. It looks pretty shady to me, too. I think somebody may have
been
leery of being discredited.
Right.
Making murders look like suicides is something that the deep, dark state is exceptionally adept at.
Yes, exactly. And the slow kill, turning healthy people into having illnesses they're doing it to me. And I saw the difference when I was living in my car for 6 weeks in between my move and getting my new house. And my health reverted back to its normal, healthy self. No tinnitus, my hair grew back, my toenails were perfectly formed in its usual pink color,
And then I move into my house. My hair's falling out. I'm radiated. My nails have turned different colors. Burn marks on my face, my legs. It's unbelievable. These are sick, pathetic losers. And it takes a whole pack of losers to hunt down one little old woman, one man. It's absolutely horrendous. I still have a hard time wrapping my mind around this.
Okay, I have about 30 seconds left here to work with. And I would like to thank you, Lorraine, and you, Chris, for calling in and paying your respects.
Well, and what else can we do?
Make a pact and call each other. And this goes for everyone listening. We have to call each other. I mean, sometimes just a call will just brighten somebody's day and bring them right out.
Yes.
Okay,
you're right.
I'd like to say Godspeed to Kim and good night from Boston, Massachusetts. My name is Frank Adams.
Corporate media dominates the American opinion. Finding independent voices that counter this avalanche is becoming increasingly difficult. With the endless corruption running rampant throughout our government, independent voices are needed more than ever to battle the offensive against our freedoms and liberties. As a listener of RBN, no one understands this concept better than you. Now it's up to you to do your part. The time has come for you to take action and begin broadcasting the truth to hundreds or thousands of people every month. Sound impossible? Quite the contrary. With pointed slogans from LibertyStickers.com, you can reach countless sleeping Americans unaware that they live in a real-life wonderland. LibertyStickers.com has a huge inventory of political bumper stickers and messages that reflect the truth about our government, our politicians, and the future of America. With so many in stock, there's one perfect for you. Visit us today at LibertyStickers.com. Again, that's LibertyStickers.com. Do your part. Your voice is important. Let it be heard.
This is RBN, the Republic Broadcasting Network.